Yo, 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 what's good? We back. We are back. We are back. Talk to me, people. What is good? I need to know who's going to win tonight. I need to know. Let it be known. Who's going to win? Shakur Stevenson or my man Jermel Herron, man? And what did y'all think about that weigh-in? My man said, Eric All Gas said, what's cracking, coach? What's good? Big Watt said, upset. We got an upset coming tonight? And still... what up, James Jones? What's good? Domino Effects at Jermel Herron. Okay, we got some people rocking with Jermel Herron, man. We got some people rocking with Jermel Herron. The fight's on right now on the ESPN Plus app, so make sure y'all go ahead and check that out. Make sure y'all go ahead and check that out, man. Should be a good one. It should really be a good one. Randy said, no prediction, but I'm excited to fight. Excited to watch, I should say. Yeah, man, I'm excited too, man. How did y'all feel about how Shakur Stevenson handled himself in that weigh-in, man? How did y'all feel about that? Let me know if anybody got any feelings or anybody who's seen it, you know, touching the belt, being a little bit disrespectful. Did y'all feel that was good for the sport? Or do y'all feel that, you know, he's doing too much? Or, you know, what did you think? Man, Anthony B says Stevenson, 7 attempt round TKO. Food Jai Justin said it was great for the sport. He likes how Shakur Stevenson handled the weigh-in. Okay. Randy said, I don't feel it was genuine and he went over the top. Sometimes you just have to show up and fight. So we got a little mixed reaction when it comes to that situation. You know what I'm saying? I was surprised. I mean, you know, I was a little surprised with Shakur Stevenson, man. You know, I feel like he's a quality kid. I was surprised that he was acting like that, man. Domino Effects that Shakur is childish and Herron is going to take the WBO belt off and whoop him with it. Damn. Man, I don't know, man. I don't know how easy it is to beat up on Shakur like that, but we'll see. He won already by letting him touch the belt. Same thing Tank did to Barbos. It's going to be interesting, man. This is a good fight. I'm definitely going to be on here after the fight. I'm excited for the Canelo plan. Did you watch the All Access? I did not catch the All Access, but I am going to watch the All Access 100%. Definitely going to check that out. I haven't been watching All Access, none of that stuff, basically since 24/7 when Mayweather was popping with that, man. So, you know, I'm going to start watching them again. When is the fight on, coach? The fight is actually on right now. It's playing downstairs. I'm going to actually go downstairs and watch it. But it's on right now. Matter of fact, let me see something. Let me see if it's on my phone right now because I do got the ESPN Plus app. Let me see something real quick. If it's playing right here, if it's still on my phone, you know, we'll see what's going on with this. Yeah, the fight's actually playing right now. So right now they got Sean Porter and Bud facing off. You know what I'm saying? Right there. You know what I mean? Talking a little bit about that. So I'm going to keep it right here. I'm going to keep it on right here, man. You know what I'm saying? I can actually do a play-by-play. I've never done that before. I know a lot of guys go live and they do like the as the fight's happening, man. You know what I mean? I've never done that before. But right now you got Terrence Crawford talking. So obviously they're in some sort of a standstill. So... Ali grandson about to fight. Okay, that's dope. They've been building up pretty good. All Access, Also Boxing, finally putting some good fights on. Love to see these guys fight four times a year, man. Yeah, man, it's good to see these guys getting active. A lot of guys' careers got held, you know what I'm saying? A lot of guys' careers got held. You had, obviously, you know, Teofimo held back. My man Tevin Farmer hasn't fought in 2 years. Just a lot going on with boxing and fighters not being active. So it's good to see these guys starting to roll again, hopefully in 2022. We can just be consistent with it. You feel me? Walks out at 10:30. What time is it right now? It's early. It's 9 o'clock. 9:11. And it's real early, man. Super early, for sure. Just wanted to come on here and see what y'all thought, man. I'm actually surprised. Surprised that more people aren't talking about this fight. You know what I mean? This is a quality boxing match. Shakur Stevenson is a quality fighter. Jermel Herron's a quality fighter. Like, this is a really quality, a good quality fight. A fight that, you know what I'm saying? More people should be talking about for sure. Tio is my favorite fighter right now. He's developing quickly. What's wrong with Farmer? Farmer, there's nothing wrong with Farmer per se. It's more so the business side. You feel me? It's more so the business side. So you've got, like, you know, it's just not as easy as just getting up, picking up a fight. You know what I mean? And unfortunately, you know, you got Jojo Diaz fighting, you know what I mean, again. Two times Jojo Diaz is getting a fight before Tevin. And Tevin defended the title, with, you know, against him. Had a rematch clause, the whole nine. Didn't get the rematch. Now you got Jojo fighting Devin Haney, which should be an interesting fight. Who do you guys think is going to win that fight? But, you know, unfortunately, Tevin's just dealing with a lot of business stuff behind the scenes. So we'll see what happens with Tevin's career. Would you coach AJ? Absolutely, man. Why wouldn't I? You know what I mean? But I would want to be the head trainer. I wouldn't want to be, you know, a second, third coach like I've done in the past, you know, for a situation like that. But yes, definitely I would work with Anthony Joshua. Why wouldn't I? Love all the content you put out, Coach. Thank you so much. I appreciate you, man. I appreciate you tuning in, man. I appreciate everybody who tunes in, shows love, shares, comments, you know, keeps this going. Last week, man, after that Wilder fight, we had 1,500 people in here, man. Crazy, crazy. I don't know if it was just perfect timing. That thing went crazy. And if so, what would be the game plan versus Usyk? You know, personally, I think that Anthony Joshua didn't have a good game plan when he fought Usyk. I thought he stood in front of him too long. He didn't utilize his footwork enough. When I say footwork, I don't mean, you know, a bunch of lateral movement. But, you know, he didn't really step back when them punches was coming in. He kind of just stood there, got hit with everything. You know what I mean? If you were going to press, he should have pressed a little bit more aggressively. Me and Eddie talked about that. There was two approaches we could have took. That AJ could have took, but for the most part, I would, you know, have AJ focus a little bit more on that jab for sure. I think he should use that jab a lot more. He would have let his hands go a lot more. I think he didn't let his hands go enough, and I would utilize getting out of range a lot more. He kind of just stood in the middle, stood in the pocket, didn't do anything, didn't catch shots. He was basically just getting hit. So there would be some adjustments made there, you know, distance control, footwork, you know, the jab for sure, and punch output, definitely. How do you think both these guys can win against each other? How can Jermel beat Shakur, and how can Shakur beat Jermel? Man, you know, this is really interesting because I haven't really sat there and paid attention to Jermel Herron that much. I've seen Shakur fight numerous times. I actually been in the gym with Shakur and watched him spar in person. So Shakur spent a lot of time here in Jersey, Philadelphia, and I got a chance to see him. I saw him fight in the amateurs when he was an amateur. So I know Shakur. Jermel, I never really seen Jermel do too much in the ring, honestly. So I think I might have seen him once or twice. You know, Jermel seems like a good all-around fighter, but Shakur is really a special fighter, even though I didn't like how Shakur Stevenson looked in his last fight. I thought he was just a little bit too defensive, a little bit just holding back too much. Wasn't impressed. It seemed like when he got touched, he went super defensive, and I wasn't a fan of that approach. But that's one fight out of many that he's looked great in the past. So I think that Shakur Stevenson just needs to do what he does, just be himself. And I think that Jermel's gonna have to dig deep. You know, Jermel's gonna have to really dig deep in this fight. He's gonna have to impose his age, his life experience, not just his ring experience. Because I don't know who's more ring experience out the two. But what I will say, life experience, you know what I'm saying? He's been to the Marines, he's freaking been to war, if I'm not mistaken, you know. So he needs to bring some of that life experience into that ring and, you know, show him that this is deeper than just boxing. And that will help Jermell Herring if he's willing to do that. But other than that, man, you know, it's going to be a very, very difficult fight for Jermell Herring, without a doubt. What do you think about the Crawford Sean Porter fight? I think it's a fucking great fight. Definitely a great fight. I think that Sean Porter is going to do what he always does, which is be a great competitor. But I just think that Terrence Crawford just has things edging on his side. I think he's the harder puncher. He could switch both stands. I think he could fight on the inside, and I think he could box on the outside. I think Sean Porter, provides difficult, a difficultness because of, the way he lets his hands go. And obviously, he's actually a clean boxer, and he has lots of world-class boxing experience. So he's definitely a threat. But I just think that the edge goes to Crawford. I think, Crawford's got a good momentum. He's very hungry, very determined. Could punch, he's taller. I think the edge goes to Crawford. What do you think about Jarrod Anderson? You think he's going to take over the heavyweight division? I think it's too soon to tell. Jarrod Anderson looked good last week. But again, who did he fight? So I'm gonna sit here and say that Jarrod Anderson still has a lot to learn, a lot to improve on. So we'll see where it goes. Do you think people are doubting Rolly too much? You know, part of me says yes, people are doubting Rolly a little too much, only because Rolly has shown that his unorthodox style and the fact that he's so strong and a little bit just like rough around the edges can provide difficultness for anybody. So I think that people think saying that he's going to get knocked out in one round, two rounds. Yes, it's possible that those things can happen, especially when you're a super aggressive and careless fighter that it seems that Rolly is. But we've seen in history that guys like Rolly actually prevent problems for a lot of guys. He's kind of like a modern day Mayorga, you know what I'm saying? So it should be a really interesting fight. Definitely a interesting fight to watch. I'm excited for that fight, believe it or not. Pretty excited. Jermel's gonna have to control this fight. Pays pressure and dog Shakur. Yeah, I mean he's gonna have to, but you know the problem with Shakur has really good distance, really good timing. So we'll see. I spoke to Mel earlier tonight. I'm Team Shakur. Shakur already said he was gonna fight his way. It's up to Jermel to put the pressure on Shakur. Shakur has the highest defense percentage in boxing. Yeah, I mean he's been really, really consistent with just not getting beat up on. So he's hard to hit, man. He doesn't use a lot of head movement to, you know what I'm saying? Like Shakur Stevenson, everything with him is just like an in and out flow. You know what I mean? You don't see him slipping and rolling and doing all them type of things. He kind of just ha, and then he's back, you know, ha, and then he's back, you know, that Olympian style. you know, that high level amateur style. So he's a difficult fight. Looking forward to Jada Kiss walking out Jermel. Damn, I ain't know Jada Kiss was walking him out. That's dope. Hey, coach, I bought your Philly show and counterpunch video. I learned so much. Thanks, heaps. Johnny Chan, thank you so much, man. I appreciate you showing love and support. And as always, you know, we got the CA Power Hour. It's a chance to plug it in. CA Power Hour is 75% off. I'm going to keep that rolling. So anybody who watches this gets that 75% off. Black Friday deals early. You know, I'm going to hop on here after the fight and talk about, you know, the fight. So definitely be on the lookout for after the fight. Oh, this kid just got hurt. And this kid, man, see, this is what I'm, oh my goodness, this guy got no defense. Who's watching this right now? I don't know who either one of these guys are. But this kid, he's standing in a Philly shove position, but he ain't doing it. I can tell you that. Oh, man, he got clipped with the right hand over the top. Oh, he's going to go. Damn, who's watching the fight right now? As you can see, I'm watching it right on my phone as I talk to you. Coach, I really like that hat. I have to get one. I appreciate you, man. I haven't been selling these hats yet, but I'll let you know when they're for sale, man. I appreciate you. Oh, he dropped them. Oh, it's over. Good job, ref. Good job, referee. Stop the fight. This kid ain't got nothing. This kid ain't got nothing. Was that Muhammad Ali's grandson? When's that ground up course dropping? That build you from the ground up course. I expect it to be out next week. Tomorrow I am doing the final overview to make sure everything's intact. My team's been working behind the scenes, getting it going. So build you from the ground up will be out next week. Maybe I'll just drop it on Halloween. You know what I'm saying? What do y'all think? You know what I mean? Should I just drop it Tuesday or Wednesday? Does it really matter? Let me know. My man, Real Dude, thank you for the super chat. Since I can't train my son, he's been training in Hawaii and using your videos for shallow. I thank you big time. Damn, man, that's really dope to hear, man. You know, I hear so many people. I got so many testimonials, man, over the years with the courses. And it's really, really humbling when I hear parents and fighters, you know, using. I've had professional fighters purchase my courses and DM me and say, I'm a professional. But they're, you know, from smaller towns and stuff, and they don't have access to the information. And they actually say it helps them in their fights, man. And, you know, it's just me teaching, not knowing what you're going to actually do with the information. But a lot of guys are taking the information and applying it. So, you know, that's what the purpose of it is. Learn the information and apply it, not just learn it. Don't be a guy with a bunch of education, but you have no application. So, you know, this is dope, man. Appreciate you. Okay, I didn't know who that was, man, but he beat the hell out of this boy. You should add a testimonial page to your website. Yeah, I may. I mean, I put a few little screenshots of what people had to say. You're right, I really should. During fight camps, do you work fitness or fitness boxers, people who want to come in and just hit the mitts that don't fight? Yeah, absolutely, man. I do that all the time. Lately, I've been limited because I've been focusing more on like recording and behind the scenes stuff with my online stuff lately. So I haven't been working with so many fitness clients. But yeah, I mean, all the time, man. Most coaches, that's how we got to make a living, right? Like most coaches, you know, if you depend on fighters to make money, it's very difficult. Fighters only fight but so many times a year, and fighters only get paid but so much per fight. And then you're only getting a percentage of the purse, you know, 10% for most head trainers. And that's a very difficult way to make a living. You know what I'm saying? So you have to figure out other ways to make money. You have to be creative, whether that's training clients, you know, doing the courses, you know, all different things you could do, group classes, personal training, you know what I mean? So you have to get creative. Coach, why do I close my eyes when punches are coming? I think that, you know, if you're closing your eyes, you need more experience. I think that's something that happens in the beginning stages. You know, you're like, you know, but once you get comfortable and you're just like, boop, 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 you know what I'm saying, doing your thing, it's kind of easy to just flow. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely easier. Just even pros close their eyes from time to time. But if you're constantly closing your eyes, how are you going to see the punches, right? So, you know, you just learn to weather the storm. So instead of sparring, maybe work drills. Find a partner and have them throw punches at you and you block, you block, you block. You know what I mean? You slip, you roll, you do the basics. And then from there, you know, you get comfortable with punches coming at you. Same thing with the mitts, right? If I'm a coach and I'm constantly throwing shots at you like a fighter would, you know, you learn to relax under that pressure and just catch the shots that I'm throwing, that I'm throwing. So that's why it's so important that your coach throws the mitts at you like a real boxer, not just pity-pat mitt work or always have you throwing, right? You also have to work on blocking. So you just need to get used to seeing it happen over and over, and eventually it goes away. Teaching to teach is a lost art. The way you explain things while you train people helps in many ways, including myself. I appreciate that. Randy said, I try to stay away from that, but I always get in the fighters first. But I, yes, I do as well. Yeah, I mean, it's a preference thing, man. I know coaches that work with pros that do not touch regular clients. They're strictly pros. And more power to them, man. But I work with everybody, man. You know, for me, boxing is more than just competition, more than professional boxing. For me, boxing is just a lifestyle. That's why I'm always like, boxing life, boxing life, boxing life. Because for me, boxing is everybody. You know, everybody can benefit from boxing. You don't have to be a fighter to train like one. That was my motto when I owned the gym. You don't have to be a fighter to train like one. And on the flip side of that is we're all a fighter in one way or the other. So for me, even if you're not a boxer, professional, competitive, I have absolutely no problem bringing you through the process, teaching you, because it's just fun, man, to watch people learn to develop, you know, the skills, and then they're able to defend themselves. They build confidence. They're, you know, it's just a lot of benefits, fitness benefits. Like when I teach fitness boxing, I don't just do the fitness boxing, right? Like I really teach you how to box, and fitness is just included. So I'll make guys jump rope, shadow box, teach them how to shadow box, hit the back. They go through the process because that is an exercise. So I don't need to make you do like a Billy Blanks Tai Bo type deal to give you fitness, if that makes sense. I also just started watching your YouTube and follow you on IG. Appreciate you. Talking about IG, man, let me go ahead and promote this to my IG. I hope you guys bear with me for a second. You know, I'll be doing this sometimes. Instagram, make sure y'all pull up. I'm live right now. We talking about a fight's happening. So if y'all want to chop it up with me, come in these comments. I'm about to bring people on here too, man, so y'all could talk directly to me. So pull up. All right, let's keep it going. The fights are actually on right now, guys. Fights are actually on right now. I got it playing on my phone. If you got the ESPN app, you can actually watch it. They got Shakur Stevenson talking right now.
Time world champion, two different.
Yeah, they got Shakur Stevenson talking right now, training with his coach. Kay Kimura. I know Kay. I've seen him. Well, I don't know Kay personally, but I've seen him around in the amateurs. You know, when I went to the nationals with my fighters, he's been around working with amateurs at a high level for quite a while. No, I'm not going to stream it. I don't know if I'm going to stay on this whole time. I was going to actually try to watch the fight, enjoy it, eat a slice of pizza, chill out, and then I was going to come back on and talk about it after. But, you know, right now we just chopping it up for a while. So since I'm kicking it with you guys, I'm just going to stay here for a while and talk to you guys. It's Boots Ennis really the real deal? I would say he is. I definitely think Boots is the real deal. I just think he needs more time to develop, prove himself a little bit more. But, yeah, he's the truth. Salute, Coach. Thanks for the discount. I purchased all your premium courses, and I have been improving my boxing skills tremendously. Yo, these are real people hitting me up right now. I truly appreciate y'all, man. Listen, I really do appreciate y'all. And every time I do this right here, the CA Power Hour, I got to say, you guys do jump on it, which is smart because I only do this when I go live. And sometimes they're not 75% off. Sometimes I do 50, sometimes I do 75, sometimes I do 60. I switch it up depending on the feeling. But sometimes I'm feeling good, man, and I just give it out for cheap. And the reason why I do this so cheap is because I know a lot of people want to get it, and they're on the brink of spending the money. So they'll go ahead, and what they'll do is, this is what always happens. People will buy the cheapest course. So a $100 course would be $25. They're like, what do I got to lose? $25. If it's trash, who cares? It's $25, right? You spend that on, look, I just bought a pot, pizza, and wings, and that came out to like $30-something, right? So now you're getting a course for $25. But then what ends up happening, people be like, I like it. I'm going to get another one. And then I'm going to get another one. And the next thing you know, you're getting every single course. So, you know, that's why I do the deals. You know what I'm saying? I do the deals because when I do the deals, I know that once you purchase one, you're probably going to purchase another, another, another. So that's how I make a living. That's how you guys get to learn your boxing. Everybody's happy, right? There's no games here. There's no gimmicks. I'm selling you something, but I want you to benefit from it. So I make sure that I put real stuff in there. You know what I mean? A lot of people may be like, oh, he's trying to sell you something. Yes, I am trying to sell you something, but something with value. You feel me? Like, that's what this is all about. Me selling you something that you're going to get value from. Is Farmer going to fight anytime soon? You know, I don't know. Honestly, I've been waiting. I'm going to see if I can get Tevin Farmer on here. Would y'all like to chop it up with Tevin Farmer? If I can get him on here, let me know. Bill Reed, I'll pay you. Pay me for what? What are you talking about, champ? I'm not even sure what you're talking about. Yo, with Zane. Yo, Zane, what up, man? What's good, Zane? Big shout out to Zane. That's my nephew right there. He's actually downstairs in the living room hopping in my live. Big shout out to my boy Zane, man. He could have been one of the best boxers in the world, but then he chose football. So we'll see how football goes. You know what I mean? We'll see how your football career goes. You could have been the best boxer, but, you know, we'll see. I'm going to go ahead and drop a link in here. Let's see who wants to chop it up with me, man. Who want to talk about this fight real quick? I'm going to do a couple, and then I'm going to get up out of here, enjoy my food, and then I'm going to hop back in here. Hop in here, somebody. Come chop it up. My bad. I'll get to that question next. What advice would you give a person who's extremely passionate about boxing and still want to box but only have one eye? Damn, that's an extreme question. I would say train, you know, don't have any expectations to be a world champion, right? I don't think you'll get cleared to fight professionally with one eye, but train, shadow box, hit the bag, hit the mitts, jump rope, do your core exercises, do your road work, learn the skills to the best of your ability, and, just enjoy boxing. That's what I'm saying. Boxing isn't just for competitors. Too many guys put too much pressure on themselves to you know, be a world champion. Why not just enjoy the beautiful sport of boxing and learn the skills? Ladies and gentlemen, I'm dropping the link right there in the comment section if you want to talk about something real quick. I'll do a quick Q&A. We could talk about this fight predictions real quick. Hit that link, hop up in here. Of course, if you ain't scared, you know what I mean? Who you got tonight, coach? I think Shakur might just be a little bit too much, but we'll see. Either way, I wouldn't care who won, put it that way. CA, where you located? Right now, I'm outside of Philadelphia. I'm in the greater Philadelphia area. I like that Canelo Alvarez hat. You got jokes. You got jokes. You're funny. You got jokes. Yeah, nah, man. Y'all know this a Coach Anthony hat. Y'all know the deal. Don't try to play with me. All right, y'all. Y'all moving too slow. So this is what I'm going to do. I am going to go enjoy my food, watch the fights, and I will be back on here after the fight. So y'all make sure y'all go watch that fight so we can have something to talk about. All right, make sure y'all go watch that fight. Shakur Stevenson, Jermel Herring. Check it out. And then we'll talk about the outcome after. And take advantage of the CA Power Hour, the 75% off. Take advantage of it. I'm leaving it up there right now. I want to thank everybody who pulled up. We'll talk some more later on tonight, all right? So, what time is it? It's 9:30. As soon as that fight's over, I'm pulling up right back in here, all right? So, see y'all soon.